10 Dark Secrets from Conservative Asian Countries. Asia is the biggest and most populous continent on the planet. Although many Asian countries have begun to adopt Western moral ideals and adopt a more liberal outlook on life, particularly with regard to sexuality, many still live in a conservative environment. Numerous elements, including culture, history, and religion, contribute to this tendency toward conservatism. Many conservative Asian nations, however, keep some of the harshest moral standards in the world a secret. 10 virgins in Cambodia are for sale. Cambodia is one of Asia's poorest countries, with 75% of its people living below or just above the poverty line. Numerous forms of sexual exploitation have emerged as a result of this severe circumstance, including the widespread but clandestine trafficking in virgin women. The largest human rights organization in Cambodia, Lakato, calculates that between the ages of 13 and 18, thousands of young virgin girls are sold each year to affluent Cambodians or foreign visitors. It will be challenging to address the virgins for sale issue in Cambodia since it seldom fits into strict categories of sex trafficking. Almost always, the mothers, fathers, or other family members sell the young girls. Depending on the buyer's budget and the girl's physical beauty, the selling price can range from $800 to $4,000. The concept that having sex with virgin females endows men over 50 with magical powers to stay young and stave off sickness is to blame for the prevalence of this issue. The majority of purchasers are well-to-do businessmen or politicians from Cambodia, although virgins are also sold to males from Singapore, Thailand, China, and other Asian nations. 9. The virgin-only policy in Indonesia. Female recruits for the police and military in Indonesia, who are normally between the ages of 18 and 20, must submit to virginity examinations. Advocates for human rights have criticized these investigations as crude and unprofessional. The two-finger technique is used by doctors who conduct the testing. In this treatment, the doctor uses two fingers to enter the vagina and one finger to enter the anus. Many of individuals who underwent these gruesome and excruciating tests experienced trauma or humiliation as a result. The purpose of these humiliating virginity tests, according to Indonesia's armed services, is to ensure that no women with a poor habit, such as having premarital sex, will become military personnel. Within the nation's military, there is a presumption that women who lost their virginity outside of marriage are unfit to serve as soldiers. Additionally, these virginity tests are employed by organizations other than the military and national police. It is also known that organizations like the civil service and local governments test people's virginity. 8. Dolphin hunting is cruel in Japan. Modern values and tradition frequently collide. Modern standards would view something as barbaric or inhuman even while tradition would suggest it is okay. This is the situation in Taiji, a little coastal town in the Japanese prefecture of Wakayama with 3,500 residents. Taiji citizens follow a brutal, savage hunting custom every year. The local government permits its fishermen to kill 2,000 porpoises and dolphins from 7 distinct species from March to September. International activists began to spread the word and protest against Taiji's dolphin hunt in 2009 after the movie The Cove, which highlighted the practice's cruelty, came out. According to environmentalists, the custom of dolphin hunting actually began in the 1960s, and money is what drives this horrible ritual. When compared to live dolphins, which are often sold to aquariums for $100,000, the meat of a dead dolphin can bring between $400 and $500. However, ardent proponents of the activity assert that it is a significant part of the town's history and culture, and that the hunting of dolphins and whales has been a historic industry and economic lifeline since the 17th century. 7. The war against witchcraft in Saudi Arabia. The outlawing of magic is a bizarre and harmful obsession in Saudi Arabia. The Islamic monarchy established a specialized anti-witchcraft unit in 2009, whose duties include looking into claims of witchcraft, destroying spells, neutralizing cursed items, and educating people about the perils of the dark arts. Sadly, migrant workers from Africa, Indonesia, and Sri Lanka make up the majority of alleged magical practitioners apprehended by the anti-witchcraft unit. Saudi Arabia forbids the practice of any other faith save Islam. It is common to presume that migrant workers who are observed engaging in strange folk rituals or carrying strange religious artifacts conduct witchcraft and sorcery. Additionally, Arabian employers take advantage of this weird preoccupation with black arts. Employers occasionally use accusations of witchcraft and sorcery in response to migrant employees' complaints about their working conditions, such as not being paid or living in appalling conditions. People accused with practicing magic frequently go without justice. The majority of migrant workers are forced to defend themselves because they cannot afford attorneys. Unfortunately, they frequently struggle with Arabic, and translations are frequently either unavailable or inaccurate. Worse yet, the capacity to defend against the charges appears to depend on the whim of the particular judge assigned to the case. A judge could, for instance, restrict the defendant from challenging the testimony of the witnesses or disallow the entry of his attorney. 6. The Temple of Sex in India. The nation's own Brahmin priestly caste, the British invaders, and the Muslim empires that once dominated the area are only a few of the causes of India's tendency toward conservatism. But unlike today, India's ideas on life and sexuality were not as rigid back then. India's population accepted sex and had a more open view of it for hundreds of years. The Kama Sutra, the first sex treatise ever written, was inspired by this acceptance and celebration of human sexuality. It also led to the construction of sex temples with intricate sexual imagery that would shock modern-day India's Orthodox society. Nothing compares to the temples located in Khajuraho, a small hamlet in Madhya Pradesh, among all the religious buildings in India that express sexuality. They were constructed by the Chandela dynasty between 950 and 1050. Only 22 of the original 85 buildings still stand. This religious complex was listed as a UNESCO World Heritage Site in 1986. The temples of Khajuraho are the perfect representation of India's formerly quite open attitude toward sexuality. The engravings on the walls show startlingly strong sensual activity. They display bestiality, threesomes, and orgies involving humans, females, and animals. Additionally, several of the shown sexual positions are so acrobatic in style that it would be nearly impossible to replicate them in real life. 5. Bhutan's hidden happiness secret. Bhutan, one of the world's happiest nations, has a somber but potent secret to creating lasting peace, thinking about death every day. 5 times a day, people are urged to think about their mortality in Bhutanese culture. It's interesting to note that science supports Bhutan's lethal happiness formula. The University of Kentucky's Nathan DeWall and Roy Baumeister ran an experiment in 2007 that revealed, despite the fact that contemplating death can be psychologically stressful, people's autonomic systems seem to start looking for positive thoughts. Bhutanese people do not dread death and even consider it to be the key to true happiness for two reasons. First, there are various possible methods to pass away in this tiny realm. The winding, perilous roads of Bhutan could lead to a person's death. They might consume toxic mushrooms, be mauled by bears, or simply pass away from exposure. Second, reincarnation is a belief among Bhutanese people. They accept death because they believe they will have another chance at life. Bhutan created the Gross National Happiness, GNH, index as a result of its great emphasis on happiness. This far-off nation has disregarded the idea that GDP is the only indicator of wealth since the 1970s. Bhutan instead assesses its development and progress using GNH. 4. Death Squad of Davao in the Philippines. Davao City is ranked as the 5th safest city in the world by numio.com, a website that collects poll responses from the public. Given that the city is situated on Mindanao Island, an area of the Philippines that is rife with Muslim insurgents, Islamic terrorists, and communist insurgents, this is pretty remarkable. Davao City has managed to boast a high safety index despite its location being relatively risky because to the vigilante organization that operates within the city's limits. Human Rights Watch has charged the Davao Death Squad, DDS, with the murder of over 1,000 drug traffickers, street kids, minor offenders, and other people. In addition to executing criminals, the DDS is infamous for assassinating its own members who might reveal the vigilante group's clandestine activities. Human rights activists claim that former Davao City Mayor Rodrigo Duterte is responsible for the DDS. In reaction to these charges, Duterte stated that if elected president of the Philippines, he would execute 100,000 offenders. Duterte triumphed in the most recent Philippine presidential election, much to the chagrin of his detractors. Filipinos might anticipate a Philippine death squad in the upcoming months if he stays true to his word. 3 contemporary slave farms in South Korea. One of Asia's richest nations is South Korea. But despite its wealth, sophistication, and advancement, this nation nevertheless struggles with a rudimentary issue, slavery. On the isolated islands of Sinan County, around 2/3 of South Korea's sea salt is produced. These rural locations are where contemporary slavery is most prevalent. Despite working at least 18 hours per day, the bulk of the employees, the majority of whom are disabled or homeless, receive little or no pay. Additionally, these masters physically torture these slaves. The fact that virtually every resident of these isolated islands is aware of the mistreatment the salt miners experience makes it much more frightening and distressing. Pretty about everyone on the island, S, should have been hauled to the police station and charged if the cops had thoroughly looked into the issue. According to accounts, local police authorities are aware that slavery exists in their jurisdiction but decide not to intervene. In fact, a lot of people have been charged with assisting the plantation owners and preventing the slaves from fleeing. 2 mass female sterilization in Uzbekistan. The Uzbek government has been secretly sterilizing its female population in an effort to manage its expanding population. In this Central Asian country, the government presents an annual plan with a set quota for each doctor. Doctors must sterilize at least 4 women per month in urban areas. Gynecologists are required to sterilize 8 women every week in rural areas, where the situation is more serious. Sterilization is typically an option, and many women decide to have it done for pragmatic reasons. However, because having numerous children is regarded as a sign of success in Uzbekistan, married women are reluctant to undergo sterilization. Few women expressly accept to having their sex removed, thus the authorities resorted to performing the procedures without the women's knowledge or consent. In fact, the Uzbek government has claimed that its record of protecting mothers and babies is good and should be regarded a model for countries around the world despite consistently denying the existence of forced sterilization programs. 1. The teenage brothels in Bangladesh. Bangladeshi males favor curvy girls, unlike their Western counterparts. Many young prostitutes use orexin, a steroid also used to treat allergies and inflammation in people, because they desire to look healthy and chubby. In Bangladesh, an impoverished country in South Asia, prostitution is pervasive. Male clients can have sex with female prostitutes for as little as 60 cents. Due to this incredibly low rate, the girls may serve up to 15 males each day. Sadly, 12-year-old girls make up the majority of prostitutes in Bangladesh. What's worse is that the bulk of these girls were given to human traffickers by their own family for as little as $245. These young ladies are coerced into taking orexin by their sardarnis, madams, in order to draw in more customers. Because of the over-the-counter medication's appetite-stimulating effects, the girls acquire weight swiftly and seem mature and healthy. In Bangladesh, prostitution is permitted at age 18 only. Sadly, orexin is quite addictive, and long-term use can cause diabetes, high blood pressure, migraines, and skin rashes. In addition, this harmful medicine has the potential to impair immunity. That's for now. We appreciate you for being here. View more our channel videos.